Many people claim to have a fear of bees. The fear may be linked to a distressing or unpleasant experience. For instance, feeling the pain associated with a bee sting, or having a bad reaction to a bee sting could lead to a fear of bees. Or this may be due to a movie you watched about killer bees, where thousands of bees invaded cities and killed people through their deadly, venomous stings. Creepy-looking insects with six legs, four wings, and five eyes are believed to have existed for about 30 million years. It is estimated that there are over 20,000 bee species worldwide, including the honeybee, which originated in Eurasia and had been spread around the globe as a domesticated species. Today, wild bee species live on every continent except Antarctica. While honeybees can and do sting, the purpose of stinging is purely a defensive move. They sting just to scare away their attackers, not to kill them. In general, bees are not aggressive creatures. They sting only when they or their colony is threatened, or they feel so. Honeybees, with hives filled with honey and larvae that need protecting, are generally more aggressive and likely to sting compared to solitary native bees. If you are afraid of bees, don't worry. You are not the only one afraid of bees. Even elephants, the largest animal on land, are afraid of bees. Elephants are so terrified of bees that they will flap their ears, stir up dust, and make noises when they hear the buzz of a beehive. Knowing the elephant's fear of bees, farmers in Asia and Africa used beehive fences to protect their crops from elephants. Honeybees are social and cooperative insects. In general, there are about 35,000 honeybees in a colony, all working together. A hive's inhabitants are generally divided into three types. They are identified as workers, the queen, and drones. Workers are probably the only bees that we usually see. These are female bees that are not sexually developed. They are the ones who collect pollen and nectar from flowers, build and protect the hive, clean, circulate air by beating their wings, and perform many other societal functions. Compared to workers, the queen's job is simple. It's limited to the laying eggs that will spawn the hive's next generation of bees. Usually, there is only one queen in a hive. If the queen dies, workers will create a new queen by feeding one of the female larvae an exclusive diet called royal jelly. This special food enables the worker to develop into a fertile queen. Queens regulate the hive by producing chemicals that guide the behavior of the other bees. Male bees are called drones. Usually, there are several hundred drones that live in each hive during the spring and summer, but they are expelled for the winter months when the hive goes into lean survival mode. Honeybees have been sweetening humans for over 13,000 years. Beekeeping has allowed us to collect and enjoy the hive's golden treasure, honey, for centuries. It is widely believed that even the ancient Egyptians enjoyed the sweet reward of honeybees' hard work and offered honey to the gods. When we are talking about honeybees, it's interesting to know the way they communicate. They have two primary methods of communication, those are movement and odor. Interestingly, when they find the location of the best flowers, they are communicating that to the members of their community by dancing and by walking around in loops, while shaking their furry bodies. They communicate the direction of flowers and how far away they are. Although small in size, their contributions to our ecosystems are enormous. It is fair to say that life on Earth as it is today would not have existed without bees. Bees are an essential part of the biodiversity on which we all depend for our survival. Bees pollinate crops. Among honeybees, Apis mellifera is the main species used for crop pollination. As a bee enters a flower to feed on nectar or gather pollen, some of the pollen sticks to the bee's body. When the bee flies, it transmits some of that pollen to the next flower it visits. This helps fertilization, allowing the plant to reproduce and generate the fruits and seeds we all consume. Over millions of years, bees have evolved to gain little pollen pouches to carry larger loads, while flowers have evolved to attract bees and other pollinators. Pollinators, which include moths, flies, beetles, birds, and bats, help at least one-third of the world's crops and 90% of all plants to spread and thrive. Among all the other pollinators, bees are the most important ones. They are truly a keystone species and a vital part of many ecosystems. According to bee experts at the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, approximately one-third of the world's food production depends on bees. Scientists are experimenting to see how bee venom could be used for different ailments to treat people. Venom is a toxin that gets into the human body, usually by a bite or a sting. Bee venom is a colorless, acidic liquid that contains both anti-inflammatory and inflammatory compounds, including enzymes, sugars, minerals, and amino acids. Melittin is a compound which consists of 26 amino acids, comprises about 50% of the dry weight of bee venom, and has been shown to have antiviral, antibacterial, and anti-cancer effects. If you ever encountered a bee attack, this is the compound that caused most of the pain. Bee venom also contains amino acid compounds called apamine and adalapin. Although they act as toxins, they have also been shown to possess anti-inflammatory and pain-relieving properties. The usage of bee products, including bee venom and honey, dates back thousands of years, as their medicinal properties were cited in religious books, like the Bible and the Quran. However, the idea of using bee venom in the medicinal field was raised from the belief that beekeepers hardly suffer from rheumatism or joint problems. Widely known as apitherapy is an alternate therapy that relies on the usage of honeybee products, most importantly bee venom, for the treatment of many human diseases, such as rheumatism and arthritis. This strategy has been used in alternative medicine for more than 5,000 years, and gained attention in Western medicine, especially in the last few decades. This therapy consists of either indirect application, by extracting bee venom with an electric stimulus, followed by its injection into the body, or directly, via bee stings. Bee venom contains several active molecules, such as peptides and enzymes, that have advantageous potential in treating inflammation and central nervous system diseases, such as Parkinson, Alzheimer, and amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. Interestingly, bee venom has shown promising benefits against different types of cancer, as well as antiviral activity, and even against the challenging human immunodeficiency virus, HIV. Many studies described the biological activities of bee venom components, and launched preclinical trials to improve the potential use of its constituents as the next generation of drugs. Although the clinical application of BV therapy is still a long way ahead, researchers believe that the ongoing work on this topic will eventually allow bee venom and its compounds to be considered definitive candidates in various therapies in upcoming years. Bees have been proving time and time again to be one of the most beneficial creatures for mankind. Whether it be from providing us with honey to the possibility of them curing diseases, over the past 300 years, most species of bees have seen a wide-scale contraction in their populations. 40% of bee species are currently at risk of extinction, largely due to human activities. Large-scale changes in land use, industrialized agricultural practices, like monocultures, and the detrimental use of pesticides, have all contributed to destroying their habitats and reducing their available food sources. Globalization has accelerated the transmission of parasites and other invasive species that prey on bees, like the Asian hornet, which can decimate entire hives in hours. On the other hand, global warming also plays a large role in the endangerment of the bee population. Rising temperatures, increased flooding, prolonged droughts, and changes in the blooming seasons of flowering plants all affect the bees' ecosystems. Like most of the other species at risk of extinction, bees are also struggling in an environment that is threatening their survival. Even though it doesn't look like it, bees are easily among the most essential insects on Earth. These scary-looking but humble, buzzing bugs deserve a huge thanks for helping to provide us with our favorite fruits and vegetables, plants to spread and thrive, their delicious honey, and for beautiful, flowery gardens. Do you know any other interesting facts about bees? Let us know in the comment section. Have a great day. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.